Hi, and welcome back to the Great MGB Rebuild Part 16. It's time for the MGB to grow up. So we've pushed her out of the workshop, and she's now taken pride of place in the actual garage next to the Tesla. And it's time to take her down to the motor registration department to see if we can get her to pass her MOT and inspection, and then we can get her registered. So off we go. So this is actually the first drive on a road. So the first task is to take her down to the local tyre place and get the front end aligned. This is actually a bit of a saga because most of the front end aligned equipment won't fit over the spinners on these old cars. So after taking it to about five different places, eventually found a place that had the right offsets for the clamps that go on the wheels and they could do the front end alignment. So we did the front end alignment, we got a certificate of alignment. So after all that was done, the day had run out, so it's back home. And because I don't have a top yet, I have to wait for a day that's actually not going to piss down with rain, and I'm going to get drenched. And then it's off to the motor registration department for its inspection. So she passed the inspection A-OK. The only trouble we had really was finding the body number stamp on the chassis that had been sort of painted over, but we found it eventually and they gave me a clean bill of health. And then it's back to the motor registration department, line up with all the plebs and eventually get issued with my special number plates, MGB666. So with registration in hand, it's off for the first drive. So we picked a Sunday morning, a beautiful bright morning, packed the bride into the passenger seat and headed off up into the Adelaide Hills, off to our favourite place, Cuddly Creek Cafe, for an early morning breakfast. So the car ran beautifully and we made it up to the cafe, had a really good breakfast and got a lot of attention up at the cafe with a lot of people paying homage to the beautiful MGB of the era. However, on getting back, everything's not peaches and cream. I found these marks on the head, and it's pretty obvious that the head's got a crack in it around this bolt, and it's weeping to the outside from the water jacket, which is a bit disappointing, so it means I've got to find a new head. But in the interim, we've chucked in a bit of chemical, what do they call it, sealing compound that's supposed to seal up little cracks and things. And that's actually stopped the weeping, so it's actually not weeping here anymore. However, I'm going to find a new head and we'll retrofit the valves and all the bits that we put in the old one and we'll fit it with a new head. But it's not actually stopping it running. It's running really well. So the crack in the head is weeping from the water jacket to the outside, which is actually rarer, but it's not impacting the performance of the engine in any way. So it's a bit of a wrap up for this month's episode. She's actually running really well, and we've taken her up to the hills a few times. We've done about 500k now. So we brought it back. We've done a full oil change and changed the oil in the engine, changed the oil in the diff. Diff is whining a little bit. So I'm going to do some more work on the, I think it's the pinion shaft bearings, because they're the only ones I didn't change. So as luck would have it, I'm going to have to pull them out and change it. But other than that, she's running really well. We're almost getting to the end of this rebuild, if you like. So the car's running really well with a few little tweaks and things, but it's now we're starting to look for the next project, and we all wonder what that will be. Got to keep me busy. You know what these old retired blokes are like. We kick it if we don't keep ourselves busy. Thanks for watching.